today we have quite a different challenge. I was inspired by a comment in our group, International Crafters, by Linda Monopoly, I believe. How do you say that? I'm sorry about the name. I'm really bad with saying names. Yes, Monopoly. And she was talking about banners. So I was inspired to do that for this challenge. I actually decided to change my challenge last minute and do this one and save my other one, my other upload for another day. Just because this one was in the air and I thought, hey, why not? So this is a triangle, and I measured this just for my pattern because I thought it'd be easier for me. I have it here measured at 7 inches across the top and 10 inches across each from the top corner to the bottom corner. So I'm using this as my pattern so I can get them exactly the same or close to exactly the same. I have burlap and I thought I was going to use that for this today. And I know I'm quite everywhere with this because it's really crazy. But this is going to be a good project. So here we go. I'm going to cut out my pattern and do the best I can with salvaging, like saving as much space as I can here, and make 3 of these for my challenge, and it's gonna be my art banner. So what it's gonna be is just like I said, an art banner. So I'm just doing it this way. It's not gonna be perfect, but that doesn't matter. This is going to be a fun, different, and fun way to do it. I'm going to move it up just a slight here so that I can fix the corner to make it a little more pointed. So I'll just make an extra little bit of a snip here. Took me a while to figure out what size I wanted. I'm just going to go a little bit bigger on top because then I can kind of glue it over my string with my hot glue. So I have one piece. Here it is. I'm going to fix up my corner end to make it just the same as more of my pattern. The same. And I'm going to again try to save. See how I'm doing this? I'm going to try to save some pieces here by just going and turning my piece and cutting. I don't think it really matters what direction I'm cutting in for the patterns of the weave, because it's just going to be interesting. And I'm going to have some of it covered anyways. I'm planning on doing some stuff over top to make it more interesting. It's kind of difficult to move this on my space when I have my computer beside me, but it'll work. We'll make sure it works. Doesn't have to be perfect, I just want close. Close is good. This is very good. And then, can I do anything with big clunky scissors in my hands? No. I can't. And I'm cutting this top half here. You can't see because I'm not holding it quite underneath my... Oh. So this burlap, you guys, we pick it up at the hardware store. And, cheap. Like 16 bucks a roll or cheaper. I can't remember what it was. It was like 15 or something. I think it was like But I can't remember how big the roll was either. So actually, I'm just going to make my lines on where. This top part I'm not going to cut, but the sides I want to trim up a little bit. So I'm just going to do that. And if it's not perfect, it's going to be good. You guys, do it in paper. I'm doing it in burlap just to be different, because I always work in paper, on paper medium, on paper. And you guys are probably going to be shocked that I'm actually using something other than paper. But I will be adding paper to it, so it's not going to be all that astonishing. There we go. So, yeah. So now I'm just going to add to there. I'm just going over it on the side, but you could trace it out again a little closer. I just want to have a little bit of a point. Save these scraps for your iCADs and for your ATCs. They are awesome. Let me tell you. And then one more. This one's actually pretty right on. I just want to maybe bring it to more of a point right here. My banners, not very pointed over here. There we go. It might not be totally perfect, but good. It's all good. So we don't forget, we're gonna have to glue it over the rope that we choose. And then we're going to decorate the front. So this is the challenge for this day. It's going to be fun. So I'm doing 3 banners. You guys can do as many as you want. I'm going to have A-R-T, art. That's my plan. So what I have done here now at this point is just cut out these circles, and they're you guys just do whatever you want. I'm going to put these circles here and have my letter here, my alphabet letter for my art there. So what I want to do, because you know me, I like to I love doing like a little bit of mixed media collage and that kind of thing. I'm going to collage these. This is where I like to play. Don't forget to keep your scraps, because even the littlest strips, the ends, all these little things, burlap that we have, will get used. So I'm grabbing my brush for my glue, and I'm just going to start gluing. Oh, that's a gooey piece. I can't do that often. I'm going to start gluing some stuff down. And it's just going to be a little random, but I want my flavor in there. I want my mixed media type of art that I like to do in here. So yeah, of course, I'm going to add what I like and make it beautiful. So I'm adding some of this. I just happen to have this green out paper napkin. So I'm just going to do that. And if you don't like it, do it again. Do something else. You don't have to do a circle. You don't have to write a letter. You could just design it with flowers or, you know, birds, whatever. I'm just playing here, having fun with it. I have some, my tissue gift wrap tissue paper I got from Walmart in the gift wrap section. And I really just love these fonts. It reminds me of something retro or something. I don't know what, but I just love them. So we're going to do polka dots. And anything that's hanging over, I'm just going to fix up after. So it doesn't matter how big, how small. I'm just playing here, and you guys just do your own thing with it. So the whole thing is just do a banner. If you want to just do a paper banner, if you want to do just a doily banner, you go for it and enjoy yourself. Play, because that's what this is all about. It's just playing and trying new things, new techniques. It's a little bit of old with the new. I'm playing with the burlap in the big portion today, right? So that's for me. But you guys don't have to use the burlap. You can use any kind of cloth. If you want to use cloth from the secondhand store or whatever. I have on hand here pink. Somebody might recognize this paper. I just got it in a pocket letter today, which I will be uploading tonight, or actually tomorrow, because now I have to upload this one, because I was planning to do a whole different project, but then I got totally motivated. I'm like, I was going to do this. I want to do this. So thank you, Linda. So I'm doing it. Sometimes when you get just totally motivated, just into one area, it's worth going for it. Let's see. I have a couple of strips of blue. Do I want that in there? I could want that in there. So, this is just another edges I cut off of a paper napkin. So, why not add it instead of throwing it out? I'm using a lot of glue here, but hey, I'm known for that. Known for the glue. It's looking pretty cool now. Imagine with my letters on top, it'll look even better. So, I think I'm going to do something a little on the crazy side again. I have paper on here. What about a little bit of material? I think I'm going to do some material. I'm going to dry this though before I add some material scraps. So I'm actually going to add a little bit of metallic paint, and I'm going to do it in my easy peasy way with my sticks here. And I actually have these ones as well, the fluorescent colors. Or bright colors. I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to use. I'm just going to use what I use. I'm going to throw some gold in there. Because I can. I love the way these bubble up too. So I'm a sucker for texture. These are looking really nice. These are looking good to me. I'm putting some blue on the blue. This has got the blue and the pink. I like that. I'm going to throw some pink metallic on here. I'm kind of missing some pink here, but that's okay. Rub it in on the edge. Tearing it up. So just use your wildest imaginations on this project, guys. I know you guys are going to do such an awesome job, and I'm going to be like, What? It's going to be so awesome. Awesome. I'm going crazy with all the metallics. I'm kind of not rolling them up too much, because I want to really preserve this paint. I love it. I really do. I love this paint. I really did mix a lot of color in there. And I love this one. This is my favorite, too. With the gold. The gold in this has got to be my absolute favorite. This green. Oh, it reminds me of peacocks. Tail feathers. Love it. So I'm not going to go with the fluorescents. And I'm going to dry that to butter depth to give it more texture. So I'm going to over dry it. So I am done with these. I also inked the edges and cut them around and inked the edges of my artwork. And I thought that, you know, they look really cool and I like them. I have some stuff here and I'm just trying to choose and pick and choose what I want. I have lots of material and you guys, we don't use some laces, use some materials for this. I have lots of things to use. The girls are in dance and these are pieces of costumes from dances and stuff that their dance teacher, Mrs. Clark, just gives me because she works on costumes and stuff. And, yeah, so if you guys go to like a tailor or you have material, if you sew and that kind of stuff, save some of these. Cause I mean, these would be really cute on some of these things. So I'm trying to figure out, look at this. This is so cute. I'm trying to figure out what I want to use here. And, I got lots of things to choose from. I got loads of stuff from like the girls dance and stuff like that. So we can just like loads of stuff. And also, you know, lace and whatnot. There's tons of stuff that you can choose from around the house. Scraps, a pocket for a jean would be really cute. Like the jean pockets. Do I have one? I don't know. Don't think I have a jean pocket, but I do have jean and you could throw that, you know, a nice pocket and then of a jean and then a letter on it or whatever, or just a flower on it or something. So that would be cute. I am not sure on what else I want to do here. Here's some pleather. So I'm going to cut some of that, see if I like that. It's a pleather boot for a dance costume. So, it might be something I want to add to it. I don't know. To have some color. I actually was thinking, like, behind the letter. I don't know. But, I mean, it could be just another texture thing. I don't know if the pleather actually goes. But, it was an idea. Pieces of lace. Pieces of things just to try it out would be a really cool thing on here. Look at how that is. I have my hot glue gun totally ready, so you could just play with whatever you want. I have trying to find some pieces here that go together really nice. Colors, you know, you can have, oh, maybe the R would be really nice with this one here. And then we have the A, MIT. Right? And say we have like, well, what do I have here? A different piece of fabric behind it. You can just do whatever you want. There is no wrong. I'm definitely think I'm going to throw these beautiful jewels on top. So I don't think I actually need this. You could also add, oh, I just want to show you guys something here. I'm probably bumping my camera. You can also add different doilies to the back of it. Isn't that cute? So I have tons and tons of doilies. We can do that. So much to think about. So much. I have to grab more doilies. We also have beads. We could do beads. Beads! Just totally. This is beads. People give me a lot of stuff. And I just, I know I have a hard time throwing things away, guys. But, you can use that for part of the banner. These are dollar store beads, probably. Or party store beads. And I'm actually going to put my Mod Podge away now. And they can be folding banners up as well as the string or whatever. So that would make it cool. You could do beads hanging down. You can do your paper beads as well. You could just do whatever. So this is great. So first of all, before I start with this, I'm just going to grab my string and start gluing. One time, I'll tell you a little story. This was from the couch to my bedroom, and Cora was scared, and she didn't want to sleep away from me. And I talked her into holding this end with her hand, and I had the other end with my hand. My bedroom door is straight across from the couch. And if she needed me, all she had to do was tug so she didn't wake up Daddy. So, it was on the floor across, and it wasn't tight, but it was, I think it was cute. She needed to feel secure. She tugged on it a couple times just to see if I was holding on to it. And I was. So I'm just going to do the glue right across here, best I can. Hopefully, I can, this clip give me anything? So I'm just going to throw more glue on here. More glue! You guys felt that, right? Ow. So I'm doing the front. I'm gluing away from the front. So, I mean, folding it over away from the front. Now I have my glue gun in the weirdest spot so then I don't reach the cord. And it's not quite straight, but that's what it is. So I'm gonna glue these. Okay, at this point I have gotten this wool trim that I got at a secondhand store. It was Salvation Army, I believe. I used my Aileen's tacky glue to glue it all on the edge here to add a fringe. I thought that was cute. I love the color of this. Look at the color. Isn't that yellow? Peacock. And I was like, waiting. I have to upload my videos every 10 minutes or so. One went over, it went 12, just because it won't upload. And I lost, that's how I lost my last video piece by, it just didn't want to upload. So I'm going to stick that up there. And some trim here. I did hot glue these trims here. Isn't that cute? From like costumes. And I'm going to snip some of this off here. I did tie these on too. These are pieces. Trims. All this stuff is just scraps from the costumes. So it's really cool to have scraps. It might look like a pile of junk, but seriously, it could be for ATCs, it could be for index cards, it could be for anything, kind of embellishment on anything. So, I'm going with this. I'm going with this, and I'm just going to put a little trim along the top like that. I don't know if I want to have some of this on top. I don't know. think that might be just a little too much. I'm going to do this, though. So I'm doing that right now, just along the top. And anything, I don't know if I'll cut anything off from the edges or not. Isn't that pretty? Gotta love these costume bits. Now for the trim here and this, I think I'm just going to, I might add a little bit of glue, tacky glue here. Because it's just going to, it's going to dry nice and not too crazy. Of course, it's going to be all messy right now because it is. Just because. And then I'm going to just tack down the center and leave this all nice and loose. I think I'm going to do that. Maybe I will use the Mod Podge for the next part. I used tacky glue for the bottom to get into the crevices of the burlap. But I'm going to use the Mod Podge for the paper on paper. So, I'm just going to throw Mod Podge on here. Lots of gluing. I could, like, I was thinking, oh, I should just go really crazy, but I'm just not sure. I just want to be pretty. I want to kind of be crazy and pretty. I mean, you can be crazy and pretty, but I don't know. I don't know. So, you guys just go crazy. My R is not straight. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. See how well that glues already? Oh, too well. Uh-oh. Guess what? There was two layers of doily. Gotta be careful that I thought I pulled them all apart. As bad as paper napkins. That's okay. I'll just use the other one on another piece. So I'm just gonna push, flatten that out. And hopefully, oh, look at it, making a mess. So I'm going to throw this one on this side that I just used kind of up and be more careful. Oh no, I forgot to add my, I'm really getting good at this. I forgot to add piece of material I wanted back there. Hopefully it'll glue. I'm lifting it up way too many times. I don't know how it's going to go. I should maybe put tacky glue on the top. We'll see. Patience. Patience. It's got texture and it looks so nice. So now let's be more careful with what we have here. Actually, I'm going to again do the top of I'm getting my cord stuck and everything. I really need to get a better, longer extension cord. It's not going across my table. That would be helpful. So, here we go with this one. And now I'm just going to stick it directly on the paper this time. And kind of glue it down. I'm just getting it enough, so it's going to go through the burlap, but that's okay. Don't really like that side. No! Well, it's embossed. I just noticed that. So, I'm gonna have tacky glue on this side. I just I'm picky. Am I picky? I'm picky. I'll put a little bit of Mod Podge with that too. Now with this one, I don't want to forget to add my paste. Throw more Mod Podge on it. I'm going to put my tea down. And hopefully, oh, I'm going to put more Mod Podge on this. I didn't put Mod Podge on this. I am losing it. But you guys just do whatever. I hope this inspires you to think of an idea that you like. Something different. I like it. I like it. I really like the doilies behind it. It looks really cool. I was going to make little rosettes, but that was an option I had. So you can put rosettes and have them up. Because you know how rosettes are, like a little fan type of thing. They would be up on the rosette, and then you would have more dimension. I thought, well, I was going to go with that. But I thought against it, I guess. I just kind of started playing with this and liking what I have here. And I'm just going to glue this on to my edge. Isn't that pretty? Cool. There's a lot of glue on the glass, and that's why I like using my glass. It's easier to peel things off. There, it's looking good. It's looking very good. My art piece. Anything that sticks out after when I don't like it, I'm just going to go, oh, I didn't add the ruffle on this. The fluffy. Any piece that I'm just going to add to some hot glue to it, and it'll work. It'll be all good. So now I forgot to add this. Of course I did, because I'm making a video. No, I probably would have forgot anyway. I got carried away with my doily. Got carried with my doily, but that's okay because I can just roll that still wet enough. See, I don't want to use hot glue for everything because hot glue has strings and it's kind of paint and it dries thick. Sometimes it's just good to go with old fashioned gluing it down and, you know, being a little slow but steady. And getting it in. Now hopefully I can remember in 2 seconds to do my other one properly. It seems to be a problem for me to remember how I'm doing this. Alright. Alright. My fingers are sticking to it. There is this one. Now I'm just going to cut my next piece ahead of time here. That way the ball's not pulling on it. Now for this, while I'm here, I'm just going to kind of peek around here and add a little bit of hot glue. But not too much. I don't want too much. It just adds too much thickness to my project. But it'll be enough to tack it down. See? Two lines about an inch long right here. It's got that one going. This one's going to need one up here. You can just see it right here. And I think that one's pretty good everywhere else. See? The glue is really good. Tacky glue. Excellent product. Okay. We have the first one. I'm going backwards. Gonna do the gluing across. And a little cricket on that one. Come on. Come on, Eileen. I can't sing to save my life, you guys. I know you're like, oh. Like a tin can on a roof or something. What's that thing? Oh, let's see. Is there another piece in here? There is. See? Tricky, tricky doily. Okay. Oh, see? I almost did it again. I almost glued it on. Gonna glue my edges on. My frilly edges. I'm so happy to use that. I actually bought that for binding and stuff like that in mind. And putting beads on for pocket letters and all that kind of fun stuff. But look at all the uses. I got that roll for like a dollar. I thought, well, I think it was a dollar. Like, why not? So pretty. It's like a peacock. My favorite. Oh, too much purple. I like purple, but I like that blue green. Well, I got all ranges of color in there. And it's going to stick nice. It's going to stick nice. I was going to dry it with the dryer, and I'm like, what if I totally melt the fibers and wreck that lovely, fluffy look? So, no. The only time I actually use the dryer, blow dryer, heat tool, is to dry the paper, which is pretty impressive for me. Not to hurry anything else from drying. So, I'm just going to go over here with the Mod Podge. I'm going to add some Mod Podge here. Mod Podge. And I'm going to go in this direction. Soup on, oops, my Mod Podge. It's on my little crystals. Soup on my Mod Podge a bit on here, so then it will stick to the paper. And again, I got a chance to do my collaging. It was just, papers, not like magazine collages. But hey, you could do magazine collages. That would be really cool too. Something about art, isn't there? It's so relaxing. Well, you know, I have to say thank you so much, Linda, for mentioning that you had done these before on the group, talking about these. Made me like, oh yeah, maybe I should do this instead of the other project. I'll save the other project for another day. Not a big deal. There's always going to be another day. So where did I put my jewel? I think this one I was going to put on the bottom. And I was going to push. I had my roller here earlier for us. Maybe that'll help. Roll. It helps. More pressure. So I'm going to do it on the bottom. Or should I do it on? Yep, bottom. Could go in the bottom of the A like that. And this one is right here. I could add more glue to the sides, which I will do. And I'll cut that little threads off. I trimmed the other threads off before I added it, but I didn't do this one. So cool. Like, Emma could even like tie some of these on here or whatever. You could tie a bunch of ribbons. That would be so cute. Use your imagination, guys. I'm totally going over my time. I did some work between the videos because it takes so long to compress my videos into the computer, and I have just decided to do this the night before. So what I have done is I just added some watercolor crayon around here, watered it up, and a little bit of painters as well for the dark, dark black. I added a little bit more bling, did that. I also drew with my Sharpie, fine pen Sharpie around the A, all the letters actually. It kind of looks like it's stitched in there. It looks really cool. I like that. I also inked the edges here on the, a little bit on the doily, so it wasn't too crisp. I added some white painters, rubbed it in up here in the letters. And this is how it looks. I also added the stamp Cherish and inked it up here, and you can not really see it too well, but it was good. And then I added a little bit of the metallic green paint just to kind of bring it, I don't know, just to add a little bit more color because I like that tealy green. And this is it, guys. So I hope you like this project and give it a try. And give me a thumbs up and like and comment, because I love to see your comments. So that's the really cool part. And share with your friends. But, yeah. So, hope to see you guys soon. I will see you guys soon. Talk to you guys later. Bye-bye. Thank you. Yay!